and welcome to Jessica's Cooking Show. Now featuring better lighting and also better aprons. No, but really guys, there's now been too much money invested in what initially began as a joke. So today we're gonna make meatloaf. But also, I did not realize it had an hour cook time and it's like 9:30. So I'm low key eating Pop-Tarts because my blood sugar is low. So, sorry, not sorry. Some of you may remember meatloaf as a thing that I tried to cook and then filled out disastrously because I browned the meat. So what we're doing today is redemption. All right, so there's a list of ingredients, but then it just says mix well, which feels weird because some of them aren't exactly like mixable. Like there's bread in here. How do you mix bread? I'm sure the sound isn't picking it up, but it's thundering like really loud outside. So this recipe calls for one egg, and I had to buy 12. So in the comments, if you want to put recommendations for good egg-related recipes so I can use the rest of these, that would be A++. No, it's already cracked. Oh, that's a rookie mistake. Supposed to check that at the store. Yes, Mom, I know. So you guys know what my least favorite condiment is? Mustard. You know what I'm never gonna use again after this episode? Mustard. That was more watery than it should have been. There's a 100% chance I should have shaken this first. Shaking it after the fact like that helps. Why do I suddenly have 3 different kinds of salt? This is so unnecessary. From now on, all recipes use regular salt. 1 small onion. Though I appreciate that my mom called out can use flakes because like I wasn't gonna use anything else, but having permission feels better. Oh, we're gonna math it up. 3 tablespoons of minced onion equals 1/2 cup of chopped fresh onion. How much is 1 small onion? Is it 1/2 a cup of chopped fresh onion? I don't want this to just taste like onion. Alexa, how many chopped onions are in an onion?
Here's something I found on Wikipedia. Yellow onions have the highest total flavonoid.
1/2 a cup of chopped onion feels like more than what you would get out of an onion. So let's do 1 tablespoon instead of 3. I hate onions. That's a teaspoon. I feel like I just really overdid it on the onions. Gonna be so mad if this just tastes like onion. So I happen to have bread already because I bought it for like, you know, peanut butter and jellies and stuff. And I went to make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich the other day and did not have jelly, I realized like after the fact. It says 1 cup of milk and 3 slices of bread together in a bowl. But everything else is also together in a bowl. So how much does it matter? How do you mix with my hands? I'm not sure. How do you mix this? Is this like a hand situation? Yes. Mom, was this not a hand situation? Am I making an unfortunate decision? It feels a little like I'm making an unfortunate decision. Oh, there's way too much milk. Oh, no. I forgot to preheat the oven. This recipe is supposed to be so easy. Why? Why? I do appear to have a loaf of meat, which seems promising when making meatloaf. Alright, well, see you in an hour. So it made meatloaf happen. And now we're gonna try it. At this point, my real hope is that it just doesn't taste like straight onion. Good news. I taste things other than onion, which in this case means a success. I also recognize that this looks like nothing on like a really large plate. And the initial plan was to make green beans with it. But then I realized that it was gonna be done at like 11 o'clock at night. And then I got lazy, and then I wanted to catch up on SNL. And here we are with just one little piece of meatloaf on a big plate. So, happens.